Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to share with you 7 biggest mistakes that people tend to make when trying to lose weight. And before we dive into it, make sure to smash the like button underneath the video, subscribe if you're new, and let's jump right in. That people tend to make when trying to lose weight is they eat meat every single day. So here's the thing, there are several studies that illustrate people with plant-based diet patterns tend to have lower BMIs and also lower fat levels as opposed to people who eat red meat every single day. There are certain foods that are notorious for causing inflammation in your body, and that is actually worth taking into consideration because given the fact that chronic inflammation has been linked to cancer, diabetes, heart disease, arthritis, and Alzheimer's, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that word right, but you get what I'm saying, and yeah, that's some serious stuff, and I'm sure you don't want that to happen to you, right? So yeah, less meat is definitely better. And I mean, again, meat in general is a really good source of protein. There's a lot of vitamins and nutrients and all that good stuff in it that I'm sure the body needs. But the problem arises when you eat it every single day. And a lot of the times people tend to include it into their breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So it's just like way too much and the body just cannot process so much meat every single day. Like it overwhelms your system. And that's exactly what I was talking about here. It causes inflammation, you start getting puffy, you start getting like different stuff in your gut, and your stomach doesn't really function properly. Like it causes different uncomfortable feelings in it. So yeah, just golden rule, either stick to white meat. That's exactly what I do. I think I mentioned in some of my videos before that I am considered to be a semi-vegetarian, so I'm not fully vegetarian because I do eat white meat, which is poultry and fish. By poultry, I mean chicken, turkey, duck sometimes, not all the time, but you know, whenever I'm at a restaurant, usually I tend to splurge and go for an option if it's available on the menu. But other than that, like, it's pretty much what my diet consists of. Plenty of greens, plenty of veggies, and white meat. That's where I get my protein from, usually. Red meats, I don't really eat any of, like, much at all. I used to, but then, like, I just noticed that my body wouldn't process it really well. It would just sit in my stomach, taking forever to get digested. And I would get puffy and, like, you know, I would get really bad inflammation, so I just decided to completely cut it off. I'm not saying that exactly what you should do, you do you boo. I'm just saying that eating meat every day is not really good, so you might wanna look into your diet and correct certain things. If, of course, looking and feeling your best is your number one goal, and that's exactly what I strive for, and that's exactly what I preach on this channel, so just keep that in mind. Second biggest mistake is you switch to a vegan or vegetarian diet to promote weight loss. When done correctly, vegetarian or vegan diet can actually lower your cholesterol levels, decrease your heart disease, lower the risk of getting cancer, and even, of course, help with weight loss. Usually people run into two different problems while trying to achieve weight loss, lose the belly fat, get, you know, the aesthetics that they're looking for through changing their lifestyle to vegan or vegetarian, and is the following. People who adopt vegetarian or vegan lifestyle with the mere purpose of weight loss, losing belly fat, getting the aesthetics that they're looking for, what happens is they don't control their portions and they actually end up eating more of the heart healthy seeds, nuts, oils, legumes, grains, which leads to weight gain instead of weight loss. And then there's another problem that people usually run into when trying to do something drastic like changing their entire diet entirely and revamping their lifestyle. And again, there's nothing wrong with completely revamping your diet for the purposes of looking your best, being healthy, being full of energy, and just gaining all the benefits that come with adopting a healthy diet plan, something like being vegan or vegetarian does, but it's only good and you will only gain all the benefits and experience long-term success with it if you do it for the right reasons. Because what usually happens, people get into it with a goal in mind, and then once the goal is achieved, they go back to the way they were before, eating the way they did before, and that's when they experience a rebound effect because, you know, the way you lost the weight in the first place, that's exactly what you need to do in order to keep it off and be your new BMI and all that stuff and possibly even getting leaner moving forward, you know, toning up and all that stuff. Because as we all know, getting rid of that like last 10 pounds is the hardest to do. So if you want to be successful with a vegetarian or a vegan diet, you kind of need to fall in love with it and do it for the rest of your life. Otherwise, you're just gonna have to experience the yo-yo effects. You'll lose weight, and then once you're off the diet, you gain it all back. And in some cases, you gain even more weight once you come back into your normal, usual routine, the one that you actually like and enjoy. So I hope that you kind of like caught the thought behind this mistake that people usually tend to make and how it makes sense. Let me know in the comments below if you ever experienced something like this, because I could never do a vegan diet. I can't. I don't understand why people would ever do something like that unless they have some problem with animal protection or something. I really don't know. But for me, like, I know it would just never work. Like, I love being a vegetarian, and I know maybe like hardcore vegetarians don't really consider me a true vegetarian because I do eat white meat, but at the end of the day, I do what's best for my body because I listen to it and I want to do what is best for me and what is doable for me on a day-to-day basis without really having to use too much of the willpower, because as we all know, willpower is very finite and you honestly do not want to mess with it because eventually you are going to break, and we don't want to go down that downward spiral at all. So I hope you got my point there. The next mistake that a lot of people tend to make is they grab foods that are labeled fat-free, gluten-free, sugar-free, and all that kinds of stuff. You buy into the marketing instead of looking at the nutrition label and seeing exactly what you're getting. Reading the actual ingredients and all the components that go into the product is a really big key to experiencing long-lasting weight loss. Not only you educate yourself to be mindful with what you buy, but also it's best to make an informed decision to buy something that is actually good for you and be beneficial to you, as opposed to buying into the marketing tactics. The other day I was at the supermarket and I wanted to buy some bread, and there was, let me grab it real quick. So the closest supermarket to me is Trader Joe's. So obviously a lot of the foods that I'm gonna show you moving forward is gonna be from that store. So I looked at their brand that was gluten-free, and I actually was tempted to reach for it and buy it, but then I decided to follow my own advice and take a look at the nutritional label in the back. And I was like, all right, let me compare it to some other, because like I know what I really like. I like rye bread with multigrains, and I wanted to be not too many, I wanted to contain not too many calories because I'm, you know, conscious about that. So I compared it to this sprouted wheat multigrain bread with all the good stuff in it. Like it's made with organic sprouted wheat berries, rye flakes, and flax seeds. It's like really good, and it's not gluten free. I couldn't care less about gluten free stuff. I really couldn't, because like that other bread that I compared this one to, it honestly had no vitamins whatsoever. Like, really. And I think it was even more calories per slice too, I think. So this one, it's like 90 calories, per slice, and that one was like 130. So I guess you see my point. I thought about it and I was like, oh my god, this is so profound. I have to share it with my Foxy Fit babes, aka my subscribers. So yeah, take that into account and don't forget to look in the back of an item and check the nutritional label and all the stuff that comes into the product, what it's made out of, and do not, again, do not buy into these marketing tactics that they're trying to sell you on, just because they know that these are like the buzzwords that you're gonna gravitate towards. The next big mistake that a lot of people make when trying to lose their belly fat is they eat standing up, and I am surely guilty of that too. Every time I eat something or munch on something standing up while making dinner, I catch myself and I literally have to remind myself of that too. But I mean, I'm not really trying to lose weight. I'm at the point where I'm kind of like maintaining it. I'm not really following any diets as of right now, any programs, any protocols like specifically. So I'm relaxed, but I'm still mindful of these little things because they do matter and calories do add up if you eat standing up. What happens is sometimes people will reach for that bag of chips and munch on that while standing at a pantry or whatever, trying to decide what to cook for dinner or for lunch. Or sometimes they would like munch on things while they're cooking their dinner. That's what I usually do, especially if I'm hungry and impatient. But you don't realize that this snack food is added calories to, you know, the meal that you're about to have after it's cooked and done, right? So just practice mindful eating and sit down and enjoy your food. That's what I have to remind myself too. It's kind of like a reminder for both of us. So sit down and enjoy your meal as it is right in front of you, as opposed to eating food willy-nilly, because that way you will see exactly how many calories you're consuming, and there, you know, it'll be so much easier for you to track your meals and calories and all that good stuff. And yeah, at the end of the day, you'll just feel better and you'll just know what's up and what's going on. And yeah, it'll just make your tracking life so much easier, especially if you're following some sort of a diet or protocol or something like that. And this brings me to my next point, to the next mistake that a lot of people make when trying to slim down, lean out, and get healthy. And it's this: your servingware is too big. Here's what happens. When you go to a restaurant, and I notice this, they usually bring you meals in like really big plates. I don't know, psychologically, it's their tactic that they're doing for sure. They're trying to tap into your subconscious mind and assume that you're eating more food than you actually are. That usually happens in like French restaurants or like really high-end expensive ones. But even like just normal, I don't know, 3-4-star restaurants, even diners, I noticed, they still bring you a big plate of food to devour. And there's been a lot of different studies done on this, that if you just eat using smaller plates and smaller forks and spoons, and maybe not knives, but like definitely smaller spoons and forks, it just significantly improves and increases your ability to lean out and control your eating. And yeah, it's a proven fact that if you use smaller appliances and smaller servingware, you will end up actually eating less. The next mistake is you add artificial sweeteners to your coffee, tea, what have you. Here's the thing. Artificial sweeteners have been accepted as the solution to adding taste and flavor without calories for the last couple of decades, and a lot of the health professionals were like embracing them wholeheartedly. But now there are so many studies that came out that link artificial sweeteners to obesity, and I'm sure that's not what you want to get. So yeah, and the reason being is consuming stuff with artificial sweeteners in it actually promote you eating more of like sweet stuff. And because you give your body artificial sweeteners, something chemically happens inside of your body that actually makes you crave actual sugar or more sweet stuff. So you just kind of like end up eating and reaching for more sweet stuff as a result, which causes overeating and therefore weight gain, and therefore just like you start hating your life, you start hating yourself, and it's just downward spiral from there, and I'm sure you do not want to go there. So it's best to either add like natural sweeteners such as cinnamon, vanilla extract, or something like that to your coffee, especially if you're on a diet and you really don't need extra calories from sugar, or actually add real sugar, just not too much of it. For example, if you tend to put 4 teaspoons of sugar into your beverage, whatever it may be, like coffee, tea, whatever it is that you prefer to drink. So instead of doing that, go for like 2 teaspoons or even 1, depending on, you know, how good you are with your taste buds and if you can actually like pull it off. Because sometimes there are certain times when I can do 1 teaspoon of sugar, but there are some other times where I need my beverage to be sweet. I need it and there is no other way. So you kind of have to just like observe yourself and find the sweet spot that works specifically for you. But yeah, artificial sweeteners, like I would actually stay away from them. And you know, again, do not buy into the zero calorie fact, because you actually end up eating way more calories after that, you know, as the aftermath, as the after effect of consuming something like that with artificial stuff, because your body naturally will want to crave real stuff, and if you don't give it the real stuff, it'll want more of like chemically processed and carby, starchy, all that like stuff that basically you don't want to put into your system, because it just kind of like gets it out of whack. I don't know, it's so hard for me to explain it. Like scientifically, it's proven that artificial stuff is not good for you, and it's best to do either natural sweeteners that are naturally zero calorie and they don't do anything to your system except for the good, or go for real stuff is just downsize it. That's it. And the last mistake that a lot of people make is this one. You deprive yourself of any treats. So what happens usually is when people go on a diet, whatever diet they choose to do, doesn't matter, they kind of just like struggle through it. They cut out anything that they actually like and enjoy eating, and they suffer every single day until they lose the weight, and there is like no rewards along the way. It's like so boring. And then the rebound effect happens and the cycle continues over and over and over again. I'm sure everybody who like was on a diet at some point experienced it. They always say there is no happy ending to an unhappy journey, and this applies here. So if you deprive yourself from any treats whatsoever, you actually kind of make your journey miserable, unpleasant, and very unhappy. And therefore, yes, you may achieve whatever weight loss you want, or so it's either gonna take you longer to do it, or you'll struggle achieving it in the first place, or if you do achieve it, you'll be bound right back and gain the weight back and more. Studies show that if you deprive yourself of any of your favorite foods, especially when on a diet, you are bound to binge on them at some point, eventually. And this binge deprivation cycle will absolutely slow your weight loss down, no questions asked. So my solution is, instead of depriving yourself and restricting your diet from all the favorite foods that you actually like to eat, which ends up happening is like you basically, by that behavior, you're setting yourself up for a binge session at some point. So we want to avoid all of that. So instead of doing all of the mentioned above, just reach for at least something. Allow yourself to have like a tiny piece of something that you actually really, really, really love and enjoy, and savor it and milk it at the end of the day as like your mini reward for a job well done, whether it's a piece of chocolate, your favorite beverage, or a single serving bag of chips or some crackers or chocolates or whatever it may be. Sometimes people like to schedule cheat days into their diet so that way they have something to work towards and, let me rephrase that, something to look forward to at the end of the week for a job well done, basically, for doing really well the entire week, and then they can actually let loose on a Sunday and indulge in their favorite foods. With control, of course, portion control is always in effect. We cannot forget about that because we really don't want to offset all the good work that we've done prior to that. I don't know how I feel about it. If it works for you, do it. Me personally, I don't like depriving myself of anything. So if you're like me, make sure to check out my 80-20 rule for weight loss. It's like 80-20 rule diet or something like that. I forget. I'm gonna link it up above and also in the description box below. Check it out. It's a really good video. It's gonna allow you to enjoy your favorite foods and still be on a diet, losing weight, getting lean, and being healthy at the same time, but without all the, you know, negative aspects that come with diets, which means deprivation and, you know, that leads to binge eating and all that good stuff that we do not want to happen. So make sure to check out that video. It's a really good one. I'm sure you'll like it. And on that note, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And of course, if you did, make sure to smash the like button underneath the video. I wanted to come up with like a clever way of encouraging you to smash it. And yeah, I don't know if I succeeded or not, but you know what to do. Also subscribe if you have not done that already. And of course, as always, I will see you in my next video. Bye. Oh, I almost forgot. There is a video that I made a little while ago and it's all about how to start a proper diet. So also make sure to check that out because I'm sure it'll help you too. Okay, bye for now.